The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Trader's Edge with Steve Rhodes. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-873-7618. The Trader's Edge. Now, Steve Rhodes.
Good afternoon from TFNN. Welcome to the July 17th, the wonderful Wednesday edition of today's Trader's Edge show. I'm your host, Stevie Perseverance Rhodes, who absolutely knows that each of us should always be pioneers of our future versus prisoners of our past. Hope everyone out there is having a great day. Hey, let's make sure we have an extraordinary one. And of course, the easiest way to do that, the only way to do that, is to always remember that life is happening for us, not to us. That's right. When you and I make that one little 2x4 shift, it means we can find the goodness in every set of circumstance that happens to us. Today, you and I, we're going to go check on the circumstance of these markets. We're going to go figure out what those bulls and bears, what those buyers and sellers are communicating to you and I just past 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I want you to know that I'm absolutely grateful for your presence here. But more important than that, during this next hour, I'm here to serve you. So feel free to pick up that phone. You can dial on in 877-927-6648. Would love to hear from you. If you can't dial in, we've got you covered. Let those fingers do the walking. That's right. You can send me an email, steve@tfnn.com. If you'd be kind enough to put radio show question in the subject heading, of course, in our Tiger's Den, any ping will do. So let's go ahead and get this show started on wonderful Wednesday. Of course, this is Tiger Financial News Network. I'm Steve Rhodes. Welcome to Lush Show. Right now, the Dow off 42 points. All the indices in the red with the exception of the semiconductor index, which is up 0.7% or 10 points. Nothing substantial to the downside other than the transports. They were up big yesterday. Remember, we identified wave number 7G, and I said, be careful. Well, that's proven to be the case. We're down 310 points as we speak, nearly 3% to the downside. Spot volatility index still below its 50-day exponential moving average. We're going to want to keep an eye on that right now, printing out at 1315. Gold having a strong morning, up $12.60, as is silver, up 27 pennies, trading out at 1595. Light sweet crude back 69 cents. That's up a little over 1%. Leading the charge to the upside, dollar-wise, Cintas Corp., CTAS up 7%, over 7%, 18 bucks. Azimil Holdings up nearly 14. Seattle Genetics up about 12 bucks or 19%. To the downside, it is Norfolk Southern up 13 bucks and change, nearly 7%. Amazon off 11, that's a 0.5%. Union Pacific down about 6% or $10. So the first thing we're going to do here was, in essence, yesterday's request that apparently I must have gotten wrong for Lee B, who is looking for an entry point into GBTC. So here's what we know. Let me just go over this for each of you out here. Really the same set of tools that you and I use for all the instruments, all different time frames. Here's the Bitcoin Trust ETF. And your key resistance level here, Lee, I want to make sure I know that you're looking for a long position. Figure out your risk reward. Right now, the reward is 1890. That is where, on a monthly basis, that is where Bitcoin broke down. So the counter trend rally, if that's all that's underway here, would stop at about 1890. Hasn't been tested yet. We've seen price get up towards that level, close to 18, but not to 1890. So that would be, in my opinion, what you'd be looking at as the reward situation. Now, if we look at the weekly chart, we're just stepping back here. Do we see any kind of a top? Well, we don't have wave number 7. We've got wave number 6. That took place about 3 or 4 days ago. Price is pulling back. You would expect price to pull back when Stevie's red line turns green. It did that back here. It looks like around May 24th. It tells you of an impending test that is coming. That test is going to be price and that line. Well, in this case here, it turned green, so that's a positive. What you're looking for, that level is going to be 1187. So 1187 is a number, Lee, I would put down on a pad of paper. You want price to get down there, test that, and then reject that level. That's what the weekly time frame shows us. The daily time frame here for Bitcoin shows that price right now today is testing the bottom of its daily profile, 1251. If you see a close below 1251, and right now there's not anything to suggest that we won't see that, whether that's today or not, I don't know. But price here should pull back to 994. So you're asking for that price, 994. However, it's with this caveat. I need to see what pattern is unfolding as price gets back to 994 and whether or not that level holds, because if it doesn't, you're looking at 678. At this stage of the game, keep those hands in the pocket when it comes to at least the charts here for GBTC. Let's go to a caller. We've got Wesley who wants to Tony from Wesley wants to talk about gold. Tony, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. How are you?
Hi, Steve. How are you?
Very good. Thank you.
And thank you for helping me. I'm looking at the gold stocks, and I think they're kind of overbought. I was thinking of taking a position in one of the direction. David, Uncle Sam, Tom. I was wondering how that looks to you on your chart for short-term play.
On dust. Okay, so here's what I would say at this stage. You and I, Tony, we're going to go check out the patterns inside of the XAU, because the XAU has really been the vehicle that has been providing great signals. And the signal right now is that today is going to be the eighth bar of a Tom DeMarc setup pattern. In that pattern, it can be bars number 8, 9, or the bar following 9 that could identify that top if one is to occur. So today could be the day, but I would not take the trade at this stage because we don't have any signals to suggest that that is the case. There is also a secondary pattern that is underway, which is prices moving higher and doing it with less relative strength. Now, that pattern requires some type of bearish reversal candle in order to confirm a top. So I would not take the trade inside of dust unless you know something that my charts are not suggesting to me, and I would wait for a confirmation of that pattern out here. There may be it, so I'll summarize it for you this way on a daily basis. The XAU may be forming a top. It could be the high today. It could be tomorrow on Thursday. It could be the Friday. Now, not all of these 9 counts turn into topping or bottoming signals out there. So you have to watch the price action as you come into that level. But you've got a secondary pattern out here, which is an even better pattern, the Rhodes Momentum Indicator signal, and you would want to wait for a bearish reversal candle before you would consider taking a stab at going short the mining equities out there. Are you able to watch this on Tiger TV? Can you see the chart that I've got up?
I get you on my iPhone right now, but okay. I'll go back and look at it afterwards, you know.
Yeah, so you're on to something. I just think that right now there's nothing to indicate that it could be today, but let's not do the could be's. Let's just wait for confirmation. The buyers and sellers have one role for both you and I, and that's to generate a message for us. And they're not smoke signals. They're really cool signals. And so when this market is ready to top, if these patterns continue to be out here, it'll be a bearish reversal candle that will give you that first indication that at least sellers are going to go ahead and think along the same lines that you are as we speak.
Okay, I do think we're getting close, though. Do you?
Could be today, could be, or tomorrow, or Friday. Here's one thing I know. We should know by Monday for sure. All right, Tony?
Well, Steve, thank you very much. You're one of the best shows on radio.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that very much, and I'll send you your $5.
Take care. You already done more than enough for that. Bye-bye.
Take care. All right. We'll be right back, folks. Dow's off 48 points.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you'd like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at the general markets. John in the Tiger's Den was kind enough to post something for the Denners in there. We'll go ahead and share that with you. And that is one of the tools that that John likes to use. He likes to use the Tom DeMark sequential system. And, you know, go out and buy his book. It's a great book. You'll have to read it a couple dozen times before you totally get it. I still have to keep going back and reading it. But here's how the sequential system, in essence, works. If you are watching us on Tiger TV, yeah, I've automated the count system. And when you get to this 13 count, which you'll see a 13 in both red and blue. 13 is the blue is the sequential and counts, and the red is the combo counts out there. And the little black numbers are the TD setup 9 count. We're not going to spend any time there at the moment. But what we can see is that two trading sessions ago, you've got those 13 counts. Now, just getting a 13 doesn't mean you've got a top or a bottom. In this case here, a top because of the move higher. What you do get out here and is you're looking at the sell signal is when you see a close below the bar 4 bars earlier. So similar to the TD setup 9 count, that would be your confirmation, as John pointed out, that if you see a close below the close of July 11th, and that price point out there exactly is 2991.91, then, in fact, that would go ahead and give you that sell signal. So you're going to want to watch 2999.91. We're trading below that right now, but it's really going to be the end of the day. Now, interestingly enough, what we got with Stevie's system, the Rhodes Momentum Indicator signal, was a top yesterday. You and I had looked at that by the close, and we're taking a look at the S&P cash. We also got that on the ES Mini. It formed that three river evening star pattern out there. This is where the market speaks to us. Now, this says we have a top in place. Doesn't work all the time. If you get that pattern, you get the TD sequential. There's other things you and I will go look at. I mean, do as you wish. This is the daily time frame chart out there. We'll go take a look at other levels of support. Where is that price could be targeting out here? But there's that sequential pattern. So watch that 2991 2991 level, 2999 level out there for the S&P 500. If you'd like to learn all about that pattern, just go buy one of Tom's books out there, a couple of his books. Now, the other cool thing now, here is what, so bulls and bears, there's information that's been presented to both you and I. We'll pull that up. These are the new TAS market profiles. We talked about them yesterday as they were beginning to form. The one in the ES Mini and the NQR, I believe that we did. Maybe we didn't. It may have popped up after the show. I can't recall for sure. But now we can see truly a struggle between the bulls and the bears. And what I mean by that, if you watch us on Tiger TV, I just want you to pay attention to the panels on the three panels from left to right. The very left one is the ES Mini. The one next to it is the NQ, and the one next to that is the Dow. Now, in the ES Mini, let's assume at this stage here, we'll assume both sides. Let's take a look at both sides of the trade out here. So we have the bearish reversal candle identifying a top. We then, as John points out, we've got a TD sequential pattern. If you get a close below that bar 4 days ago, then that's going to give you a sell signal. Now, whenever we get sell signals on anything, the very first thing that you and I are trying to figure out is where is support? Because it may be nothing more than a retracement back to support. Well, inside the ES Mini, the number that you're going to be watching is 2969.50. 2969.50. Now, that's about 30 points, 28 points below where we're trading right now. So that would be a nice move. Now, the structure of this box is bearish. What we mean by that is the center line is closer to the top than it is to the bottom. If you see today a close around where we're at, which is below 3005, that's an indication that sellers, they've got the muscle. They've got the muscle to go ahead and push price, or should be able to have the muscle to push price down to 2969. If we take a look at the NQ, similar situation. However, no types of real confirmation per se with regard to its market profiles. What I mean by that, you can clearly see the bearish structured box. Top of the box, 79.75 and change. Center line at 79.23. Bottom at 77.94. Right now, price is tested and rejected the center of the box, where both buyers and sellers are lined up here. Won't be bullish, again, until you see a close above 79.75. A move down below 79.24, like in the ES Mini, below the center of that box, should say that there's enough strength now by sellers to push price down to 77.94. Now, here's the cool thing that I think really where we get the signal information, has the market formed a top or not? And that's going to come from the Dow Equity Futures contract. Now, when we put the Dow Equity Futures contract up on the screen here using Stevie's tools, you're not going to see a topping pattern. However, there is a small A to B equals CD pattern that is set up here, but no bearish reversal signal. You need that to confirm that sellers have said, okay, I'm ready to try to kibosh this. Well, here's the other thing. So we don't have a topping pattern out here, but what we do have is a brand new profile. It popped up about 2 hours ago. I can't guarantee that it's going to hold throughout the day. We'll look at it tomorrow, but right now we have to go with the information. We're using Stevie's advanced Doppler system here, but the cool thing is it would be the Dow that should bust through the bottom of its box before the ES and the NQ, most likely. The reason is because the bottom of the Dow's box is 27,175. Let me just expand the chart out here and share with you why that's important. The low so far today has been 27,226. So the number you want to write down on a pad of paper, you want me on that wall, and that's 27,175. Should you see a close below that, then we would say, regardless of the fact that I don't have a topping signal inside the Dow Equity Futures contract, we still have a change in trend signal here. The way that these profiles will typically work, now, typically, because when we are in some type of consolidation and a break below 27,175, we're not in the Dow is in a larger consolidation. We're up at the top of that. I'll show you that. But here's what I want to say. If you look at coming off of the lows out here from the 26, you do not see a close below the bottom of a profile. If you take a look at coming off of the highs here in May, May Day's high, once we close below that level, its box out there, which was on May 2nd out there, that was your confirmation. When price bounced up the very next day, where did it bounce up to? It bounced up to the bearish structured center of the box where both buyers and sellers are. That was that counter trend rally, and then it was the Nike swoosh to the downside out there, where it did complete a pattern on June the 3rd. I know that because we went ahead and took a long position in the newsletter June 3rd, and then again the morning of June the 4th out there. So right now what you'll be watching inside the Dow Equity Futures contract, really two things, right? The top of the box, too, 27,397. If you see the Dow Equity Futures contract close above that, 27,397, it just really is an indication that, hey, the fact that Steve's chart didn't show us that topping signal out there was because there wasn't one. Now, price could pull back to support, 27,175 and hold out there. And then we've got to say, okay, so what about the signals inside the ES and the NQ? So we're just going to have to take things one step at a time. Now, you may be wondering to yourself, you know, how is it that price, why did price stop where it did this morning out here? And you and I, we answer that question all the time. We know the answer to that question. You know the answer, don't you? Here's the 30-minute chart. TD setup 9 count. You can form a top or a bottom on bars 8, 9, or the bar following bar 9. The ES mini 30-minute chart, the low, the bar following bar number 9. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. It is that easy, folks. We'll be right back. I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Good Welcome back, folks. So the next chart that you and I are going to feast our eyes on is going to be this one here. We're taking a look at the New York Stock Exchange. We've got a line chart out here, so we're just looking at closes of the session. And then you've got the center panel. That's the advanced decline oscillator reading. What that is, what that represents, is it represents the difference between two exponential moving averages, 39 and 19, of the advanced decline data. And the cool thing about utilizing that tool is kind of like liar's poker. How do you know when to move higher or lower is BS before Steve, I can use that BS stuff, before Steve shared with you how to actually use that information. What you'll see here, and we're going to focus on right now, is the present. Green bar, little news panel number one, the top panel. And what I've marked on here is I've marked with the S&P making higher highs. Now, it wasn't the fact that it was making higher highs that I marked it. Where I began that making higher highs is when we saw the advanced decline oscillator reading. This was on June 20th, peak. And it peaked right at the 150 level. There's something referred to as 150 failure. Oftentimes, when a market is going to peak, so to speak, you'll see the advanced decline oscillator reading turned down from there. Now, price did not turn down from there. It went higher. That created the divergence, because what we have here with that advanced decline oscillator reading is a set of lower highs out there. Now, today is an important day, today and tomorrow, for the New York Stock Exchange, because the way that this oscillator works, to include this as part of your training, is you want to watch, in this case, when it gets below zero. Right now, the reading is minus 2252. But I don't know what the market breadth, the advanced decline data, is going to look like at 4 o'clock today. If it looks similar to the way it is right now, you'll have one reading below zero. Now, the way that this works out here is you really need confirmation. And confirmation means a close below that level tomorrow. Now, this is kind of cool with regard to how you put this together with what we're looking at inside the other markets out there, the S&P, the NASDAQ, and so forth. Because if price closes below today, stays below today, then the meaning is that sellers really are in control. It doesn't matter to me the price movement. This is just simply trying to understand who's got the ball. We're playing football here. Who is in control of the game out here? And you know, like musicians can have a one-hit wonder. Well, one day below and then closing back above says sellers were never in control. But that was a fake out in the liar's poker game. So you'll want to watch the New York Stock Exchange, its advanced decline reading at the end of today's session, as well as tomorrow, to see if there is continued follow through. Just as long as it stays below that zero line, that's the follow through to say, okay, sellers are now in control. Now, the bottom portion of our screen out here is taking a look at the spot volatility index, which right now is trading at 1320. The 50-day exponential moving average number is 1474. In general, when price is below the 50-day exponential moving average, tells you there's plenty of liquidity in the market. It doesn't matter whether the reading is 1474 or 4474. The folks who will tell you that the number is important just simply don't do any analysis to understand that number, meaning the spot volatility number and its 50-day exponential moving average. Things will not get rocking and rolling to the downside unless price closes over that. So the number to be watching is 1474. It's going to take likely days, maybe not, but I can't forecast how long it's going to take. But you're going to want to watch that, because if, in fact, we've got an advanced decline oscillator below zero and the spot volatility index up above the 50-day exponential moving average, that's when things can really begin to fall apart. So summarize it all. We've got great signals, great information out there. We've got the TD sequential count that John of the Tiger's Den pointed out. We've got the Rhodes Momentum Indicator top inside the ES, meaning the S&P, the NASDAQ. We've got other Wave G readings. We'll go ahead and pull those over to make sure that you're taking a look at it. So everything is in place for a top to form. Now, what we're looking for are confirmations, or confirmations of a change in trend. How do we get those? Well, we get those by taking a look at those TAS market profiles, those support levels. Those are key. We have new ones for the ES, the NQ, and the Dow. So that is really important to be watching those levels. And then we can finally put the icing on the cake. We'll be paying attention to the New York Stock Exchange, its advanced decline oscillator reading, and what it says. As I mentioned, the daily time frame chart out here, you've got a confirmation of wave number 7. That is letter G on our system out here. We pointed this out yesterday and probably the day before, so I won't point it out again to you other than right now. And what we can see here with the NASDAQ composite is the last time it made its high back in the April time frame, it was with wave number 7. Probably no coincidence that coming off of the June low out here that we now got to wave number 7 and price begun pulling back. In the case of the NASDAQ composite, we really need to see price close below Stevie's green line. It's right around, just use 82.15. It's right around there. We're trading at 82.16. So it closed below, I'll give you the real number. Let's not leave things to chance out here. 82.12.28. 82.12.28 is the number out there. If the NASDAQ composite closes below that, what it's communicated to you and I is price may just simply be coming back to where it had broken out. And that number is 79.61.46. That's on the NASDAQ composite. So just like you've got the New York Stock Exchange, NASDAQ composite, a wider swath of the market, really giving us important signal information. Watch that green line number to help you understand what the market is communicating to you. As we mentioned, the semis are the only index trading to the upside. Why is that? Well, we don't have any kind of topping signal here. When the SOX formed its high back in the April timeframe, it was with that Tommy DeMark setup 9 count. It was bar number 8. Remember, Tony and I took a look at, and my advice to him with regard to dust is was taking a look at the XAU and recognize that we're in bar number 8. Today could be it. Doesn't have to be because it can be bar number 9. It can also be the bar following 9, as we looked at inside the 30-minute chart for the ES Mini. It's inside those bars, 8, 9, and we'll call them 10 at this stage here, where you really want to be focused. And to see if you start to get some type of reversal signal information. Here, when we take a look at the semis, we don't have a topping pattern out here. Today is going to be day number 6 of a TD setup. So it looks like if the semis are going to top, it might not be until Friday, Monday, Tuesday, if this pattern remains. It doesn't have to remain out here. It can go away having a lower high than a bar 4 bars early. But I don't want to confuse you. If you'd like to learn that pattern, just simply subscribe to Mastering Probability, even if you do it for 29 days because of the 30-day money-back guarantee. The transports. We talked about the transports yesterday. Go back, listen to the archive. We took a look at it and said, man, look at those transports go. But we said, be careful. Why? Because we knew there was a wave number 7. Letter number G on my system out here. That is a cool tool, just as the TD setup 9 count. When the Dow Jones transports made their high in April, it was with that 9 count pattern. Now, what price has done here, right, when you get a topping signal, price is supposed to go back and test support. It has tested support. It's sitting on support right now. Support here happens to be Stevie's green line. That number, just so you know, is 10488.33. We're at 10485 as we speak right now. Closing below that would suggest a further retracement, even all the way back to where it broke out at 98.2195. What happens if price closes above it? Well, then you've got that seventh wave move, but you also have a test of support. It's not where you would buy, but it's also where you would not sell, because price may have found support. So it's going to be about the end of day reading inside the Dow Jones transports. But at this moment, it too looks like it has topped. One by one by one. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. We'll be right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. So we got a question coming in here from Nick. Nick writes in, he says, hey, Steve. Hey, Nick. If you look at the 60-minute chart in the Dow, and what Nick is referring to is looking at the 60-minute Dow equity futures contract. So let's go ahead and post that on the screen here. It has been in a range for the last 3 days. So if the Dow falls below 27,300 before the close, is that a signal to sell the Dow? And I'm not sure where the 27,300 number came from. I'll just make sure I give you my numbers, and then you can kind of go from there. So here's the 60-minute chart for the Dow. So what do we know about it? Well, we know that when it bottomed way back here on July the 9th on a 60-minute basis, that it was forming that Rhodes Momentum Indicator bottom. It was also forming a TD setup 9-count bottom. You got that confirmation at 7 o'clock in the morning when that bullish engulfing candle formed out there. That's a bullish. It works the exact same way. We look for bearish at the top. We look for bullish at the bottom. Now, you'll see this little tool that I've developed here. You'll see lines drawn when that pattern begins to form. But just because it begins to form is not the time you take the trade. Take an example back here is right here at 10 o'clock in the morning on July 11th. That pattern began to form. There was no bearish reversal candle. The cavalry, the responsibility of buyers and sellers is to produce some type of reversal candle if, in fact, the market is going to reverse when that pattern completes. Same thing took place out here at about 2000 hours on July the 11th out here. Now, let's fast forward to the high. 4 o'clock in the morning, July 15th, prices moving higher, doing less relative energy. We know that because my system automatically was drawing that in there. And then, voila, 5 o'clock in the morning, because we're looking at a 60-minute chart, you got your bearish reversal signal. So first, Nick, here's what we know. Trading sideways, yes, but never breaking above the sell signal on a 60-minute time frame. Now, I don't know if you use the 60-minute time frame for your sell signals. If you do, you then got the sell signal that there's been a change in trend on a 60-minute basis, and that took place at 11 o'clock this morning when price closed below 27,302. Now, maybe that's where your 27,300 number is coming from. I'll just stick with 27,302 because how can I use 27,300 when it's 27,302 sitting out right here? So this is already indicated a change in trend from a short-term standpoint. That's the short-term standpoint. If you're going to trade on a 60-minute, stay with inside the 60-minute. However, the real change in trend, because the daily chart, we took a look at it, does not have a topping pattern per se. It does have an A to B equal CD, but no bearish reversal candle. Yesterday was close, but no cigar. Price did not exceed the high or the low of the prior bar to give us a key reversal session out here. So what we have to go on, Nick, is the new profile or potential new profile. I won't have confirmation that this is what it's going to be or form, but right now it's what we have. And that says you would need to see a close below 27,175 using the daily chart to suggest that a change in trend has taken place. So, Nick, thanks for writing in. I hope that helps to answer the question. Hope I've been clear to everyone out there with regard to the Dow equity futures contract and what it is that we are looking at. John of the Tiger's Den indicated that there's a number of very good stocks here that are starting to give it up. NSC is one of them that he put in there. Let's go take a look at it. NSC, that is Norfolk Southern, moving lower today with volume out here. If we take a look at the chart, John, here that stands out to me and taking a look at it is the weekly time frame right now. The weekly time frame, just simply because price have been trading with inside that profile structure for the last several months out here. The top of the box, which was hit this week, was 207.98. Now, it's an equally distributed box. But if Norfolk Southern closes below 187.13, that's the bottom of the weekly profile, there's problems in River City. This also here is a hammer candle. That's the week of June 24th. There was enough of a decline for that to be a hammer candle. That low is 8188, even Steven out there. So close below 187.13, which is from a weekly standpoint, that there's problems in Paradise. Now, when I pull over my other weekly time frame chart, what we can see on a weekly basis, price was moving higher, doing less relative energy. We already had the first bearish reversal signal June 14th. We got another one right now. So this area here, that top of that box, weekly box at 207.98, is a real key level of resistance. If price, John, we to be able to close above that, then this would continue moving higher out here. Just do a wave count from the piercing candle on in December out there. Yeah, so you're only in on a weekly base, only in wave number three or letter C on my chart. But there's your signal. If NSC, Norfolk Southern, were to fall below, close below 187.13, then we would surmise that price is on its way back to 148.28, where it is that price, in fact, last broke out on a weekly basis. And it's just the weekly chart we were looking at, because when I put that symbol in and we looked at the market profiles, it was the one that just popped up on my visually to say, okay, that's up at resistance. What other pattern is going on? Is there a pattern that is going on as we take a look at that? So no other questions that we have yet. So let's continue to surf around. What do we want to look at next? What do we want to look at next that would be helpful to you? Let's take a look at gold having a nice day out here. In the case of gold, what do we know about it? So let's take a look. Gold has actually formed a new market profile too. And that daily box, it's with inside the prior profile, but price nonetheless is trading above the top of that daily box out there. Let me expand the chart out for you so you can see. Now, I don't know what gold is going to look like come the end of its trading session out here, but the number to be watching is 1421, 1421. If price closes at or below that, it was just a counter trend rally with inside this sideways move out here. If it closes above that, well, that becomes interesting. So I pull over the other chart out here. If it closes above that, here's what I would say. So we know that we've got a, and you can also see that where price has stopped in essence today is Stevie's green line. That number, let me give you that as what the print is as we speak right now. It's 1424.90. So I'm going to say price has to close about 1424.90, not just the top of the box out there, but 1420 Stevie's green line in order to say, okay, you know what it's going to do or likely to do, even though it's got the TD set up nine count pattern, it's likely to go ahead and make a run for that June 25th high out there. And if it does that, what it probably does is then generates wave number seven. Just like we looked at the transports, or we do, and many other, the NASDAQ composite, and many of the other issues that are out there. Remember, none of that guarantees us. None of that guarantees us that it's going to be a top. Now, if that's the pattern that unfolds out here, I can just take a look at what would then be next. A higher high above the June 25th high would then all of a sudden trigger a Rhodes momentum indicator topping pattern out there. So even though the TD setup 9 count might fail, you would then have wave number 7, letter G, and you would have a Rhodes momentum indicator signal. Of course, all of that would need some type of bearish reversal candle. But as we speak right now, really all that gold has done is moved up to test a level of resistance. That's Stevie's green line. That is the oscillator unchanged line. That's what I see when I take a look at Goldilocks. If we go take a look at Treasury bonds, they're up by a full point as we speak, so they're having a nice move as well. And they too formed a new profile, of which price is trading above that level. Maybe what price is doing is it's targeting about the 155, 15-ish type area. That's where Stevie's green line. This has got a couple of topping signals as well. Steve Rhodes with TFNN. Hey, I'd love to hear from you. Send me a quick email. We've got the two-minute wrap. Don't do that. We'll do the two-minute wrap when we get back.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is David White. Stay tuned because coming up next is the Power Trading Hour right here on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. Dow off 37, S&P off 7. So nothing, we've got topping signals in several of the indices, but yet nothing has broke. And when I say broke, what I'm referring to is levels of support, key levels of support, which right now we're going to use our TAS market profiles for that. Right now at 1:54 in the afternoon, this signal coming from the ES Mini is that price wants to push down to 29.69 or 29.99. Inside the NQ, it's uncertain. It has a bearish structured box as long as price closes below 79.24, maybe by about 5 points or so, then price can move down to 77.94. But we haven't seen that. So the NDX is the one that is, or the NQ, really that's what we're looking at. But in the NDX, here's what another number that you can pay attention to, Stevie's Green Line. This is what this would be a level of support, 79.1394. 79.13, or forget about the cents out there. Just use 79.13. If you see a close below that, then that signals that the NDX 100 could pull back to 77.35, its last breakout area. And we're really going to be keeping our eye on the bottom of the box for the Dow, 27.175, as well as the top of that box, 27.397. It's a narrow box. It's likely to change, but right now, this is what we've got, and I don't know if it will or it won't change. We'll have a better indication come tomorrow, come mañana. So we're going to be watching those things. We're going to be watching the New York Stock Exchange advanced decline line, see if it closes below zero, and then tomorrow, does it have follow through to the downside? These are the important little nuance messages that the market is providing for you and I. I don't think we're going to be worrying about the spot volatility index just yet for a few days if the markets are going to continue to move lower. But regardless of timing, let's not worry about timing. Instead, we're going to worry about the numbers. And the number right now is 1473. If price closes above that, that says we've got some rocking and some rolling to the downside. So, folks, stay tuned. Talk about rock and roll. Hoochie Coo. Who said that? Well, our favorite polar bear, he's up next. He could probably answer that question. Then after that, that's David White. After that, Tom O'Brien from 3 to 5. Stevie, Perseverance Rhodes. I'll be back with you tomorrow at 1 p.m. So have a wonderful Wednesday. Take care.